Testing 12369. Hello everyone, my name is Blame Truth. I have a Gears of War 3 multiplayer match for you here. And this match, everyone that was in our party, like, backed out. So, it's just gonna be me and Bubba tearing it up on this team. And because of that, it's gonna be an actual, like, close match. And, I've got the Savage Kantas multiplayer character here for those who are interested in seeing what it looks like and don't have it. It's pretty freaking sweet, I gotta say. But this match, I want to really explain. How did I miss this guy? Like, what the fuck did I just do there? I'm a moron. But I want to explain the importance of power weapon control. Now, for those who play Gears 1, Hotel is laid out extremely similar to the map Mansion from Gears 1. So if you have a set strategy for Mansion, you will probably do well on Hotel every time. How this guy does not die on cover there, I do not know, but he does not die. But I kill his teammate right there with a direct digger to the chest. Get owned, son. That is all she wrote for that person. But this is a tip I'm going to pass along from the Gears of War clan Zen. They have a YouTube channel and they taught me this in one of their videos. The power weapons are on a 30 second respawn timer. So after you use all the digger or whatever, it will respawn in like 30 seconds. And right there, I pick it up. I discard the area where the power weapon spawns, and I am able to get the digger pretty much every like time it spawns on this round. And this is pretty huge. Same with the flame grenades, because they're very close to the digger. I can get both of these and you know, just wreak havoc. I'm gonna launch some digger on these guys who are unsuspecting, and that's really the best time to use digger, is when they are not looking at you. And even though I only got one kill with this digger, picking up the power weapon and not getting any kills with it is better than the enemy team picking up the power weapon and getting any kills with it. So even if you're bad with like sniper or digger or whatever, torque bow, pick it up anyway. Like, it's better than letting the enemy team get it. Always pick it up. Another tip I can give you guys, especially if you're a new player, is to always spot, because I mean, I'd rather have somebody that goes negative and spots like constantly, spots enemies constantly, than somebody who goes positive and doesn't. Because the person going negative and spotting is going to, oh, nice double kill right there with the digger. The person going negative and spotting is going to net me less deaths, because people aren't going to be sneaking up behind me. I'll always know where the general location is of the enemy, and that will help a lot. So I get the digger again. I got two kills with it back there. I don't know how this guy doesn't die or whatever. I think the digger got glitched out in the plant there, which does happen. But I have flame grenades. I'm going to make use of them right here. I'm going to get a nice little like blind fire toss kill right there. And I think, yeah, I get snuck up on with the sawed off right there. And that just shows the importance of spotting. If my teammates would have spotted that guy, I would have known not to, or I would have known he was coming behind me and not to stand there like an idiot with my back turned to him. But I think I get revenge on him right here with my super fast trigger finger. No, it's not a modded controller. I just masturbate a lot, and that enables me to shoot the hammer bursts and semi-auto weapons very fast. But I go and get the digger yet again. This is like the fourth time I've gotten it this round. And again, this just shows the importance of power weapon control. Like, if you don't get power weapons, you're on an equal playing field with the enemy. You have the same weapons or similar weapons. You all can pick the same weapons. And really, it's, you don't want to be that. Like, you don't want to do that, even if you are better than the average player. Because two average players can always, well, pretty much always take out a great player just based on their numbers. But I mean, a good player that has boom can just roll through any kind of average player. And check this out. I see the guy down, and I bait him in, and I get another nice fucking double kill right there, which just gives me a huge boner because I love baiting stuff in like that. But I don't get any more kills, and I don't die anymore for the rest of the round, so I just clip that to save time because you guys don't want to see me walking around for like another minute. At least I don't think you do. Even though my character skin's really cool, I don't think you want to look at it. But I'm going to go grab frags because frags are, in my opinion, better than flame grenades, at least as far as longer situations go like this, longer range situations. I toss a nade there, get a nice kill while that person's distracted at boom. And, yeah. Really, again, it's all about power weapon control. Even in, even if you're not playing TDM, like, you want to go for the power weapons, that gives you a huge advantage. Sniper, torque, boom, digger, grenades, what have you, it all gives you a huge advantage. Even the pistols on the ground that you can pick up will give you an advantage. I was playing a guy earlier today who was just an absolute beast with the bolt hawk, and he was downing people, like, left and right with it. He almost, like, he was just laser accurate with it, and, I mean, stuff like that. I saw Bubba, who I'm playing with in this match, destroying people with the Gorgon pistol earlier today. So any advantage you can get over the enemy team is always welcomed, and you should always go for it. Even those smoke grenade spawns on, like, Old Town, you should probably stop and pick them up, because two smokes are better than none, and they can stun enemies and allow you to get power weapons, cover your tracks, all that good stuff. So, you know, any opportunity you can get an advantage over the enemy, take it. Always take it. Even if you're not good with the weapon, because it prevents them from getting the weapon, and preventing them from getting the boom shot and getting like 5 kills on your team is better than you picking it up and getting no kills. But anyway, that person's down and my teammate can't get to it, so I'm just going to finish off the kill there. That's always a smart thing to do. You don't want to, like, kill stealing sucks, but a lot of times if I down somebody and I can't get to them, I'll say take it. Or, you know, because they, if they rapidly tap A, they can get up pretty fast in TDM. And here's a stupid move on my part. I should not have done this. That sniper's over there, and I tried to fire with Hammer Burst at that guy in front of me. I didn't notice that glare until the last second, and by then it was too late, and I get my head, my dome sniped off. But they just picked up boom, and I made sure to tell my lone teammate that. I'm very good at callouts in this game, and that's one thing I kind of pride myself in, is letting them, my team know, you know, when a power weapon is taken or when it'll respawn or whatever. Another thing you can do if you do play with teams that's really good and will help you a lot is telling your teammates when you use the last bit of ammo in your power weapon. Like, let's say you fire off the last sniper shot in your sniper, and you know, if you don't tell anybody that, nobody's gonna know that sniper's gonna respawn soon. So you should tell them that when you're out of ammo with the sniper or the boom or whatever, that you're out of ammo, and that it will respawn in like 30 seconds. It'll help everybody, and if you can't get to the power weapon in time, your teammate can. You know, little things like that make a huge difference in this game. And you'll find that, I mean, just stuff like taking cover. Right here, I didn't mean to take cover, by the way. I meant to go in the door, but my character just stuck to the wall. And end up getting sniped for it, which sucks a lot, but and is frustrating. But I mean, that's my fault for not using the the alternate control scheme, which separates the roll, evade, take cover, and run functions between A and X instead of them all being A. But I played this style of control like so long since Gears 1 that it's just like it's like trying to relearn how to ride a bike. It's too difficult for me. That guy has a spawn shield, though. He would have went down, probably, because he was taking direct Lancer fire to the dome. But, you know, spawn shield screws you up sometimes. I actually charged a guy today with the Retro Lancer, and, you know, it was a charge long enough to impale him and get a kill, but I hit him with a charge, and I hear that little brrr noise that indicates they still have spawn shield, so, got fucked out of a kill there, ended up getting sawed off, but, you know, whatever. I do down that guy, though, but I have to roll away because of the oncoming enemy damage, so my teammate takes the kill. Not really a big issue because I took a kill earlier. So I'm just, right now, I'm just trying to spot him for my team, who may be across the map and stuff and might not be able to see where they're at or know where they're at. So it's always good to spot. Unfortunately, you can only spot, like, one at a time. It's not like Battlefield where you can spot multiple enemies, really, so... But, you know, always spot. It's so important. You can see people through walls and all that. Like, they're marked through walls. It's just so important, and it'll help your team and you a lot. But both teams' respawns are depleted now. And this was actually surprisingly a competitive match. I think that's because we had bots on our team for the majority of the match until new people joined, and they didn't. So it was pretty much just me and Bubba and a bunch of retarded bots trying to take on like pretty much a full team here. And it was not fun. But Boomshot respawns. I'm going to grab that, and I'm going to do some work with it. Now it's 3-on-3 here, and unfortunately I think Bubba dies right here. Or no, my other teammate dies. So there's a guy right here, I hear him through the wall there with my headset. It will take him out with a nicely placed boom shot. And I keep telling Bubba to stick with me because I don't want to have to face 2-on-1. You know, even if I have a boom, 2-on-1's dangerous because one can flank me, one can distract me, whatever. But they're making kind of a stupid play by posting up at the sniper because it's only a matter of time if they stay there that I come up with a boom shot or a grenade or whatever. So I'm going to go up here. They're going to run away around the corner, and Bubba gets killed from behind. And I know this guy's going to come up on me, and bam, he gets boom shotted. So it's sudden death right here. Last spawn for both of us. And Bubba's telling me this guy has a sawed-off. He's using ghost camera, which is super important as well. Tell me he has a sawed-off, so I'm going to bait him out and then boom him for the win. And that is all she wrote. Take that sawed-off. Shut up your ass, son. That is all she wrote. So final score is 14-3. Fairly competitive match. Hope you guys enjoyed it. If you did, leave a like, leave a comment, leave a favorite, or not leave a favorite, but take a favorite with you if you enjoyed it a lot. And, subscribe if you have it, and I will see you guys later. Goodbye.